Hello, everyone. My name is Harold Campos, PM for Azure Integration Services, and today I will present another episode of our Mission Critical series, We Speak, where we emphasize on particular and commonly used technologies in enterprise mission critical environments with Azure Logic Apps. The topic for today's session is IBM MQ, part one. We'll talk about what is IBM MQ, and the reason why we have a part one is because we have a number of scenarios that we'd love to cover that for which we don't want to take a lot of your time today. So what is IBM MQ? IBM MQ was originally introduced in 1993 under the MQ series name. It is a message-oriented middleware that provides asynchronous messaging, data transformation, and many other features. And something key is that IBM MQ runs on multiple platforms, such as IAX, AIX, IBM i, Linux, Windows, and ZOS. According to IBM, IBM MQ runs on 90% of the top 100 in the 2022 Forbes Global 2000 list. We have been providing MQ integration services and capabilities with host integration server and BizTalk server for many years already. What you see on the right side is a graphic that depicts sort of the evolution of MQ until today. I think the latest version is 9.3. This was extracted from IBM WebSphere MQ Primer, an introduction to messaging, and WebSphere by Mark Taylor. Now let's talk a little bit about the IBM MQ in-app connector for Logic Apps standard. The built-in or the in-app connector allows sending and receiving messages from MQ servers that are running anywhere. They can be running on a mainframe, on a midrange, or any kind of midrange and from the cloud. We have triggers, we have actions. We'll talk more about those later, but at the core, the IBM MQ connector allows a comprehensive set of features for integrated with MQ systems. As I said, the IBM MQ in-app connector enables connections between workflows in Logic Apps to IBM MQ server on-premises or in the cloud. The IBM MQ standard connector is a thin wrap around the traditional features that we had in our host integration server product that is called the MQ client. And the Logic Apps workflows can browse, receive, and send messages stored in an IBM MQ server. The way how we see this is all of the capabilities that we've been, the core capabilities of the MQ client that we've been providing in host integration server, but adapted to the cloud world, they have been included in the connector. One important thing is that the IBM MQ connector supports one-way and two-way secure connections using SSL. And it also supports the IBM multi-instance queue manager feature MIQM for disaster recovery. On the right side, you will see the connection properties of the trigger, one of the triggers that we have available. You see that you will have to enter the server name, port number, channel, queue manager, connect us, and they map to your current IBM MQ configuration. And then, you know, if you are interested in using the MIQM capability, the IBM multi-instance queue manager feature, so then you'll have to enter here a backup server name, backup port number. We're still working on introducing more exciting features to the connector, so stay tuned for more announcements soon on this topic. Just as a reminder, Logic Apps has triggers and actions. So when you create a workflow, you can use a trigger, which fires when a condition is met. And we have three triggers for the MQ connector. And we have actions, which represent subsequent steps in a workflow that follows the trigger. Going back to the triggers, we have three main triggers. When a message is available in the queue, just if a message is available, it triggers. Or there are two options where you can bring one or more messages in a batch manner, one with the autocomplete, which is the destructive read, and where the messages are deleted from the queue, on another one, which is the non-destructive read, which is when the received messages are locked but not deleted from the queue until a call to abort complete occurs. As far as actions, we can browse message, multiple messages, receive messages, send messages, multiple messages, complete them, and also move them to the MQ dead letter queue. Now, one core feature of the IBM MQ connector that we've been working on is the browse lock, which is equivalent to the pick lock in service bus. The browse lock returns one or more messages from a queue. The received messages are locked but not deleted from the queue If no maximum message count is provided, the default count is set to 20 messages. Using BrowseLog allows our customers to atomically retrieve and log messages from a queue in a non-destructive manner. Azure Logic Apps provide a state preservation feature to make sure that these messages are logged. So in other words, there is a dependency on the platform that that has been enabled to make sure that the messages are logged and available despite the instance where the workflow is being executed. So this is something that was enabled in the cloud. And to enable these scenarios that require this feature, it is necessary to use the following instructions. This feature is called enabling stateful affinity in a stateless connector. But you'll see that there is a lot of information here that you can use the instructions to set up this configuration. Okay. Now, on the right side, you see the properties for the trigger, the browse log trigger, right? You enter a queue name, you can decide whether to include headers or not, and then you can specify format, max message count, batch size, wait interval, and timeout interval. Okay, so now let's jump into the quick demo. Let's open the workflow. So I have created a fairly straightforward workflow that uses the trigger with the browse log trigger, okay? So when one or more messages are received from a queue, in this case, it's called a Q1 that I have in my mainframe. So let me show you the queue here, right? So this is Q1. So what it's going to do is something fairly simple. It's going to move the successful messages from Q1 to Q2, okay? Let me see if I have the tool. Yes, I do. Okay, now we'll go back to the workflow. In the workflow, we have, so we are receiving one or more messages from Q1, and then for each one of these messages, we will be sending them to Q2. If there is a, for all of those sends that are successful, we will commit them. And for the ones who are not, then we will abort them. Okay, and then we will post a message in a chat or channel. So if I go here, you'll see that I have in Q1, I don't have anything as current queue depth. And in Q2, I have 108 messages, right? Which are the ones that I've been using for testing. If I go to my tool here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to send 150 messages. So then these messages are being sent. I'll go to MQ Explorer, and then I'll see that this Q2 count will continue growing, right? So, and then all of these was processed, 258, so was processed, and then a Teams message should be received by 1210 or something like that. Yeah, 1210, browse log execution completed. If I go back to my workflow, you'll see that, let's go to the execution, and see in the run story, if it was succeeded, then I hit this one, and then we'll see what happened in the execution, which was successful. But something important to mention, yeah, there's been not a failure, right? So we can simulate a failure, but in the interest of time, we will not do it today. So we send a message, we send success, we commit them, and then in the end, they are sent to my team's channel called demo. Let me go. This is just now. The messages, they were completed. Well, they were committed here, right? They are now in Q2, from Q1 to Q2. And that was the fairly straightforward demo that I had about the IBM MQ connector. So again, this is Harold Campos, PM for Azure Integration Services. And I hope you liked this presentation today. Thank you so much and have a great rest of the day.